snacks? Milk. What? I don't have a glass of milk before I go on stage. I just can't function, sweetie. Stage? Don't worry, there won't be a stage. All you have to do is sit down. I guess. Nick, Max is really nervous. That's understandable. Hey, miss my sweeties. What? You don't think I should fly, do you? You know, you've got to make a good first impression. When I enter the room, maybe I should fly in and warm up the crowd a little. Yeah, that won't go well. No. We can't be having you flying around the courtroom. Just wouldn't be right. Imagine if you hit someone. Don't worry, Max. Just do what Nick says and everything will be okay. Oh, sweetie. What is it this time, Max? Why don't you try flying into the courtroom? I can see it now, the dashing young lawyer flying fabulously in from above. One glimpse of that and everyone in the room will be on your side. Max, really, no one needs to fly today. Nick, what's with that look in your eyes? I like the sound of that dashing young lawyer flying fabulously. Oh boy. And now the case of one. What? You're gonna get on with it. Oh, sorry. I just realized that the defendant's name is Billy Bob Jones. So, well, isn't the defendant also known as Maximilian Galactica? Yes, Your Honor. He does often go by that name. You know, my grandchild is a huge fan of his. I think everyone here wouldn't mind if we call the defender Maximilian Galactica. It sounds more friendly. I wonder if that is to our advantage. Miss Von Karma, your opening statement, if you please. I hope you didn't bother thinking you'd win this one, Mr. Phoenix Wright. That spirit channeling trial was a sham. I refuse to acknowledge its legitimacy. It did not count, do you hear me? She must still be upset about what happened last time. You have no chance. Zero. Zilch. Nada. I'm not losing this case. Why, you ask? Because it is not in the nature of a Von Karma to lose at anything. I guess being born with the name Von Karma is a free pass to be arrogant and annoying. At least, the other Von Karma, the dad, didn't hit me. Watch and learn, Mr. Phoenix Wright. I'll show you the textbook procedure for proving how absolutely guilty you are. Me? Guilty? What are you talking about? It will be my ultimate revenge. My daddy's gone, you know. The prosecution is finished. Let's hurry up and wrap up the waste of time. You may call your first witness, Miss Von Karma. Detective Dick Gumshoe, get up here, now! Sorry to keep you from work, as I'm sure you need every penny you can earn, Detective. Don't mention it. It's no trouble at all. I've been looking forward to this. Very well. I would like you to begin by shedding light on the events in question. At your service, sir. Alright, Detective. You may proceed with your testimony. Details of the event. The night of the crime, snow was falling until 9:40 PM, making it extremely cold out. All of the circus performers were gathered in the Big Top to practice their routines. The practice session broke up around 10 PM. The murder itself took place in the plaza in front of the lodging house at 10:15 PM. The victim was found bent over a wooden box, dead as a doornail. The cause of death was blunt force trauma that snapped a vertebrae in his neck. I see, he was beaten to death. Here's the autopsy report for the victim. The court accepts this into evidence. I wanted to read that before I analyze his stuff. A blunt object. Very well, Mr. Wright. You may begin your cross-examination. Yes, Your Honor. Okay, let's read. The night of the crime, snow was falling until 9:40 PM. Yeah, I already know that. Okay, so... No, no! I didn't mean to do that. I meant to read it. Like a good person. Time of death, 10:15 PM. cause blunt force trauma to the back of the head. So keep that in mind. Alright, I'm gonna do this. Let me ask you about the snow. It was nearly a blizzard up until the night of the crime. Did it pile up? It wasn't such a big deal. Maybe about an inch and a half was on the ground. Snow froze in place and stayed on the ground until the next day. The snow. Let me see. There's gotta be more to this. Huh? What's the matter, Nick? I need to take a look at the court record. Mr. Gumshoe, what were the members of the circus doing on the night of the crime? All the circus performers gathered in the big top to practice their routines. When you say all of the circus performers, who do you mean? Everyone but the dancers and staff were there. Regina the Animal Tamer, Mo the Clown, Ben the Ventriloquist, of course the Defender, Maximilian Galactica, and his victim, the Ringmaster. Oh, I almost forgot, Regent the Tiger was there as well. Out of curiosity, what about the circus monkey? When I was investigating yesterday, he happened to snatch my wristwatch. Detective, you are welcome to file a police report after these proceedings. We already know where it is. The practice session broke up around 10 p.m. I love how it said cheap wristwatch, by the way. I just remembered that it actually said those words. Something like a cheap wristwatch or something. After the practice was over, where did everyone head off to? Whoa. Didn't mean to do that, sorry. Regina was playing with Regent, while Mo went back to his room tired from work. Ben the Ventriloquist went to the front gate, absorbed in his own world. The Ringmaster and Max went off to the Ringmaster's room to talk privately. Talk privately, huh? That's awfully suspicious. You wouldn't happen to know what they were talking about, would you? Seems they were negotiating Max's salary. Actually, Max was asking for Regina's hand in marriage. The murder itself took place in the plaza in front of the lodging house at 10:15. I'd like you to be a bit more specific about the events at 10:15 p.m. Okay, not a problem, pal. We've got a witness that tells us the whole thing. This is totally meaningless. Time to move on. Alright. We'll just have to revisit that testimony later. Detective Gumshoe, would you mind telling us how the victim met his end? The victim was found bent over a wooden box, dead as a doornail. A wooden box? That's right. The victim must have been carrying the wooden box when he was killed. Carrying the box, huh? It was a rather strange wooden box, drawn. What do you mean? Well, it was much heavier than it looked, not to mention it was locked. Locked, you say? This might be my only chance, so I might as well ask about the contents. Do you mind telling us what was inside that box? Well, when we found the box, it was locked tighter than Fort Knox, so we took it back to the station and cracked it open. All that was inside was his little bottle. Bottle? What is that, Detective? Exactly what it looks like, Your Honor. It's a condiment bottle. What's inside the bottle? It's filled with pepper. Pepper? Why in the world was it locked in that box? There was only one little bottle in that huge box. I wonder if that has some sort of special meaning. Why would pepper be in a big box? The cause of death was blunt force trauma that snapped a vertebrae in his neck. According to the autopsy report, the murder weapon was a blunt object. You've done your own work, pal. And you haven't found this murder weapon, have you? The police are searching for it as we speak. My theory is that it is something the perpetrator ran off with. You'd think so, especially since you didn't find it on the scene. No, I bet he made it disappear with magic. Well, I think we have a good feel for the details of the event now. I guess that's all we're gonna get out of Gumshoe in this case. You mean all we're gonna get out of him is that little bottle of pepper? Now that we've wrapped up with the detective, I'd like to call my next witness. I'm not even off the stand yet. Obviously. But that's due to you being slow and unable to take a hint. I don't know, but wrapped up has such a mean sound to it. I'm a sensitive guy. Thank you very much, Detective Gumshoe. You may step down. Ms. Von Karma, call your next witness. I'll have to call Mr. Benjamin Woodman to the stand. She must be talking about Ben the Ventriloquist. I wonder if Trilo will show up on the stand as well. Oh god. Oh shit. This is gonna be fun. Please state your name and occupation for the record. My full name is Triloquist. I'm an employed as... Employed? Employed. Employed as an operator.
Excuse me?
The witness called to the stand was one Benjamin... Mr. Benjamin Woodman, Ventriloquist. That robe must be cutting off your circulation. I said that I was a singer. Maybe you don't believe me. Fine, I'll grace you with a song. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no. What a lore. Exciting and daring. Guilt or innocence. Sided by a judge dressed up like a woman.
Huh? It has a good rhythm. It's just the lyrics. They leave something to be desired. So to speak.
Trilo, you know better than to insult a judge. Shut up, just look at your nose. You'd think you'd have the sense to fix it. It's so ugly I want to punch you in the face on the off chance. Swelling would up, would help. You know that your nose is the reason you'll never be an A-list star. Celebrities must really enjoy saying everything that flashes into their minds. What's going on here?
Order, order! I demand to know who the witness is.
I'm not worried about you one bit. I'm worried about getting a testimony.
You won't get anywhere trying to figure out this witness. Now let's proceed.
Oh my god. Once practice was over, I left the tent with the stooge. I mean, clown. Once we got to the lodging house, I ditched him and went over to the plaza. That's when I saw Max heading towards the scene of the crime. He was the only one heading that way. How could that punk not be the killer? Then the police showed up and took Magic Boy away. You saw Maximilian Galactica heading towards the scene? You sure of that? Without a doubt, he had only silk hat cloak and that damn white roses on his chest. How can you mistake someone with that crazy get-up and his nose stuck up so high? That's enough. I think we all get the picture. Just one thing. You said you ditched the clown. That's right, Dress Boy. Well, since you weren't with him, doesn't that mean the clown committed the crime? He's got a point. What a shame. It was a nice theory, but the clown can't be the criminal. Why is that? Here's absolute proof. A silk hat? This was found at the scene of the crime. It belongs to the defendant. Without question, he was wearing his signature hat during practice. If the clown was the murderer, there would be no reason for this hat to be at the scene. Well done, Miss Von Karma. Your prosecutorial skills are unrivaled. Well done. Thank you for stating the obvious. Mr. Phoenix Wright, what do you have to say?
Okay, I guess she's the boss again today.
Once practice was over, I left the tent with the stooge. I mean, clown. Okay. The clown. You're talking about Mo. Of course I'm talking about that old fart. So pathetic, I can't stand him. Just a little bit of exercise, his makeup is running all over the place. Once practice was over, he was 9/10 of the way to kneeling over for good. Poor guy. He didn't have any choice, so Ben took him back to his room. When it comes to being a first place loser, that guy's ahead of the pack. Then what happened? Once we got to the lodging house, I ditched him and went over to the plaza. What did you do then? I went over to the plaza and did some thinking. It was awfully cold out at night, especially with all the snow around. Wouldn't thinking in your nice warm lodging house have been a better idea? Objection! Mr. Phoenix Wright, I think you should leave the thinking to the witness. But I'm a good thunker. At least my teachings always said I was. What? That's when I saw Max heading towards the scene of the crime. He was the only one heading that way. How could that punk not be the killer? Oh god. Nope. Yep. Are you sure it was really Max Galactica? Of course I'm sure. How can you mistake someone wearing such a snobby three-piece getup? Snobby three-piece getup? Get the wax out of your ears. Lawyers nowadays, you're like talking to a brick wall. Max's three-piece getup. Jeez. Could you be any more dance altogether now? Silk hat, cloak, white roses. Thank you.
Nick, I think you should put a little bit more effort into preparing your questions. Yep, okay, good man. You saw Max and only Max, right, Trilo? That's right. And that makes him the killer. There was only one person headed that way that night. That makes quite a bit of sense. It makes Max one suspicious character. There's more to this story than meets the eye. Is there something amiss in this? There's no proof it was Max. Wait a second, there's no proof that the witness saw Maximilian Galactica. Hey, you still don't get it, do ya? So what I saw, it was Max's three-piece joke costume. Alright, let's say it all together now, oh my god. Then you should study up new celebrities. Yeah! And the police showed up, yeah, I'm gonna... wasn't meant to press that. Been on this one, Max. It's a bit strange, don't you think? What's strange? That you only saw Max. Doesn't it seem like you should have seen someone else as well? Where were you going with this? How else do you suppose the witness could have seen? Take that! That's the victim. That's correct. If Trilo was at the entrance to the plaza, he should have seen the ringmaster as well. Obviously, the ringmaster arrived at the scene of the crime before the witness. Before the witness could have seen him, anyone with sense could have figured that out. What are you talking about? The ringmaster and Max went together to the ringmaster's room. Is that according to the defendant a likely story if Maximilian Galactica was supposed to be in the ringmaster's room? Why was he just as the witness stated at the scene of the crime? I see. Seems that at this stage, I have no reason to doubt this witness's testimony. There were clearly no conclusive contradictions. He's right. A brilliant judgment, Your Honor. Let's move along with our testimony. Trilo wouldn't happen to have an ulterior motive for incriminating Max, would he? Well, Max is part of the bitter love triangle with Regina, which is probably why Max conked him over the head. Nick. Wasn't Ben the one who got knocked over the head? Yeah, I think so. I don't know anymore. Once practice was over, I left the tent with a stooge, I mean clown. No, wrong button. Around what time did the police arrive at the scene? Suppose that would have been around... Hey, what time was it? I think it was around, I'd say, a bit after 10:30 p.m. Practice ended at 10, so you hung around the lodging house the entire time. I guess that sounds about right. Wasn't it awfully cold? I can't believe you just stand outside in that weather. Well, the truth is... You shut up, you big rouge dope. Why are you telling him anything extra? Why can't you believe that we'll just stand outside in that weather? Or maybe you were waiting for someone. Who said we were waiting for someone? Mr. Phoenix Wright, we can all do without your offhand theories. But this witness, he's cracking under the pressure already. I'm onto something. Mr. Wright, who do you suppose the witness was waiting for out in the cold that night? Possibly him. Don't hold your tongue, Ben. It's your job to answer all the stupid questions. Sorry, Trilo. Gotta find a way to get more information out of this witness. Okay, that was wrong. Think about it some more, Nick. I'm sure you'll come up with something. Okay, I think I know who it was. It's possibly Regina. Who's then the monkey probably stole the ring he was planning to give her. Well, if he was waiting outside in the cold, it was for one person. And one person only. He was waiting for the animal tamer, Regina. You were waiting outside for Regina to come back to the lodging house. Am I mistaken? Is this true?
Well, you can't really ask me that question.
Who cares who I was waiting for that night? What's important is what I saw, don't you forget it.
Well, well, well. The puppet may be a bit stiff, but he's right.
Alright. There was obviously a reason why this witness was there that night. He spent all that time waiting for Regina to arrive. Moreover, even if someone else would have walked right in front of him, I doubt he would have paid them a second thought. That makes perfect sense. What did you just say? The witness saw the defendant at the scene of the crime. However, he did not see the victim on the way to his eventual demise. You accept that, then you must accept that there is a high likelihood that he could have missed someone else other than Max heading there. There is absolutely no proof that the witness was waiting for the animal tamer. I guess you got me. Alright, alright, I'll spill the beans for real this time. It's true, I was waiting for Regina. Pain. Don't volunteer things. Pain. Mr. Quist, tell us the truth this time, and I mean the whole truth and nothing but the truth. Were you or were you not waiting for Regina at the entrance to the lodging house?
I was.
I was waiting to propose to her.
You were what? Waiting to propose?
What's the matter? You think that humans have a monopoly in the marriage? That the matter of a puppet marriage is not under review in this case. You're the judge. I mean, look at your horrible outfit.
More pain.
Thanks to your bubbling, my perfect plan is not so perfect anymore. Now we have to waste time getting to the bottom of some silly proposal by a puppet. Don't be so surprised that I was going to propose to Regina. I even had something to give to her. Kept it in my pocket, waiting for my chance to propose and give it to her. Of course, I also had it in my pocket that night. It was a present for her. In the end, I wasn't able to give it to her, so I've still got it in my pocket.
You were going to propose? You a puppet?
Don't be so obtuse. Just because I'm a puppet doesn't mean I can't love.
I guess you're right.
Because I'm old doesn't mean I couldn't propose to her too.
Exactly.
His honor is looking a little less honorable right now. Okay, Mr. Wright, please continue with your examination.
Oh, did you hear that? His sighs seemed a little wistful.
About the proposal. Don't be so surprised that I was going to propose to Regina. By proposal, you mean proposing marriage, correct, to Regina.
Of course that's what I meant. What kind of stupid question is that?
I was going to propose that we become some sort of outlaw biker gang.
Right, Ben?
Yeah. Got it. That's the truth. That would have been cool. I even had something to give to her. What was it exactly that you planned on giving her? You know exactly what I was going to give to a numbskull. The only thing I could find that could match Regina's beauty. Answer his question. What was it? You're going to die when you hear this. It's an engagement ring.
Wow.
Those two nearly fell out of their chairs. Mr. Phoenix, right, joke has gone too far. Time for this to end right here. Franziska's whip looks like it's about to lash out at almost anything. One hit from that thing and we'll probably shut someone up for a long time. Pain equals bad.
Pain equals bad.
I'm just gonna go and push on anyway. It may be something of a joke, but this is a historic moment. The first time that a puppet has ever proposed to a human. I advise you to cut this argument short. I'm gonna have to agree with the defense here. Would the witness please revise their testimony? Specifically about the engagement ring. I like to stick to the facts, not sociology. Be sure to enjoy sweating the details, especially for a man in a black bathrobe. I planned on giving an engagement ring to Regina. Engagement ring. It's actually a diamond-shaped stone cut from glass. Even more brilliant than the real thing. I think Regina is gonna love it. It's just a ring. What's the matter, Nick?
Oh, there's gotta be something I can catch him on.
I kept it in my pocket waiting for the chance to propose and give it to her.
Whose pocket was the ring in?
Mine, of course. What a stupid question. You gotta be kidding me, you think bank pull it off?
I'm sorry, really sorry.
You don't have to apologize for that, he's the one who should be apologizing.
Really?
Of course, I also had it in my pocket that night. It was a present for her.
So you went to the lodging house to give it to her?
That's right.
I tried to give it to her during practice so many times that I lost count, but that uberty snob kept getting in my way.
Uberty snob? He couldn't possibly be talking about Maximilian Galactica.
I'm gonna get a hold of him. I'm gonna saw his woodblock in half, and not with magic.
Wait, that's Max talking.
Well, they always say that love creates rivalries.
What was that?
What?
Was that meant to be Von Karma talking? So what about this present? In the end, I wasn't able to give it to her, so I've still got it in my pocket.
So you were still thinking of trying to give it to Regina?
Of course I am. I spent 3 months' salary on this thing. I'm not going to give up that easily.
I wonder how much he receives for appearing in the circus. Probably way more than he deserves.
How about it, Nick?
I think it's about time to unwrap this toy's testimony.
That's the spirit, Nick. Give him heck.
Oh, the judge is that dazed look again. Maybe you should get out more.
Don't be so surprised that I was going to give it to Regina. I planned on giving the engagement ring to Regina. Kept it in my pocket. Okay, I know what to do.
And show him the ring.
Trailer, do you mind if I show you something?
What is it?
What are you talking about?
Oh, looks like they're going to double team me.
Do you recognize this ring?
That's mine! Give it back! Thief! Thief!
Didn't you just testify about this very object? I believe you said, in the end, I wasn't able to give it to her, so I've still got it in my pocket. Why then do I have it right here?
What is going on here?
That's... Ben, say something!
Don't put me on a spot like that, Trilo.
I found this in Moni's money's room.
Moni's room? You mean in a room where they put money, like a bank vault?
That filthy monkey is gonna get what's coming to him.
Mr. Quist, I would prefer if you avoid slandering innocent flats.
Flats in my court.
Well, Your Honor, money really is a monkey in every sense of the word.
I see, well then.
Money likes to go after the shiniest things that he can find and gather them up.
Shiny things?
Trilo, when was this ring stolen from you?
Well, I suppose it was that time. You know, that night, the night of the crime.
What did you just say?
Details, I need more details.
Well, it was stolen right after Max showed up in the plaza.
Right about when you saw the defendant walk past, correct?
Well, I guess you might, be able to say that. The ring might have, well, it could have been taken around that time.
It's always the same thing when the monkey's stealing things. It's just, and then it's like three pictures of the objects it steals.
Ben, what's with you?
Oh, whatever. There's nothing to do with anything, especially not who committed the murder.
I think it was Acro that killed Russell, because we haven't actually seen Acro yet.
Now, Trilo, back to the topic at hand.
I haven't admitted a thing, not I, Mr. Trilo Quist.
What did you do when the ring was taken, Trilo?
You know exactly what I did. I chased after that ring, snatching monkey money.
But you weren't able to catch up with him, were you?
It's all this slow, lovey fool called Ben's fault. While he was fumbling his way through the snow, that dumb monkey was able to get away.
It is indeed an incredible shame.
Well, this does indeed prove one very important thing.
Prove an important point? What point could that possibly be?
Ben doesn't exercise enough.
Oh shit. Obviously that one. Oh god. I didn't mean to click that.
Obviously that one Benjamin
Woodman is lacking the area of exercise. The
This is clear from the testimony we have just listened to.
He was too slow and awkward to catch a monkey fleeing through the snow. His revelation doesn't seem to be registering too well around the courtroom.
Maybe you should leave the courtroom drama for video games and rethink that one.
Well, that doesn't do prove one point.
Yeah, testimony's a flaw.
There is a huge contradiction in this testimony.
A contradiction?
The witness just testified to the following effect. Up until the police arrived, he didn't move from the entrance to the plaza. However, the witness just stated that he chased after Money the monkey. When the witness was off chasing Money, there was no one watching the plaza.
What is the meaning of all this, Mr. Phoenix Wright?
Where are you going with this little theory of yours?
I'm saying that there is no possible way that this witness saw the plaza the entire time.
That's where I'm going with this little theory, which leads me to my next point. It is entirely possible that someone other than the defendant was at the scene.
Interesting, Mr. Wright.
Well then, tell me this, Mr. Phoenix Wright.
Do you have any proof that something slipped past this vigilant ventriloquist?
Well, he obviously didn't see the victim, the ringmaster, arrive at the scene. However, that doesn't change the fact that he saw the defendant arrive. The witness is lying. He is blinded by his rivalry with Max.
Well, the defense's argument does hold water.
This witness does have a history of animosity towards the defendant.
What? How dare you? I wouldn't lie just to get that dog face in trouble. He's not even worth it.
Saw him, no doubt about it. I saw that worthless liar.
Well, just for clarity's sake, let's flesh out exactly who you saw in that night.
Told you so many times, you think you'd know my story's not changing.
You've already changed your story, sick stick boy. I'm sure you'll change some more.
Where there is one liar, there are usually many more behind it.
Exactly, ma'am. That's why we have to keep after him.
Witnessing Max. I'll give you that I was waiting the night for Regina, but that doesn't change the fact that I saw Max in the plaza that night. He showed up after I had been waiting there for about 5 minutes. He said good evening to him. I said good evening to him, but he didn't even acknowledge my presence. I'm absolutely sure it was him. I saw Maximilian Galactica at the scene. There's no way I could have mistaken someone wearing those three ridiculous symbols.
So that means the money didn't show up until after you saw Max?
That's right. Money ran up less than a minute after I saw Max.
The money snatched the ring and you went chasing after him.
How long was it until you came back to where you were waiting?
Well, let's see. I'd say about, I suppose, 5 minutes, I think.
So the victim could have arrived on the scene in that 5 minute stretch.
Mr. Wright, please proceed with your cross-examination.
So you were only concerned with waiting for Regina that night. That means you probably wouldn't have noticed if someone else showed up.
You should think about how many eyes I actually have.
I've got four. You know, four. F-O-U-R. Counting dead, of course. With that many eyes, do you really think something would have slipped by me?
Four eyes is awfully a lot of attention directed at one area, I suppose.
Yikes. The judge is even more dangerous to our case than Trilo.
But that doesn't change the fact that I saw Max.
So you saw Max coming out of the big top that night?
Of course, that's where I saw him coming from. I was staring at the entrance to that tent the whole time.
Guess that makes sense, especially since he was waiting for Regina.
He showed up after I'd been waiting there for about 5 minutes.
I said good evening to him. Oh, oops.
About what time would you say these events took place?
You're one of the dumbest people on the planet if you can't figure it out yourself. You already know the practice finished promptly at 10, and you already know that I went to the lodging house right after practice. You don't need to be a brain surgeon to know around what time it was when I saw him. Is that 10 more minutes? I'm sure you can do that. Now what time was it?
Gee, what time was it?
What time was it? Let me think about that for a second.
Oh yes, that sounds about right.
Sounds about right because that's the time That's the time that I saw Max on the scene. I said good evening to him, but he didn't even acknowledge my presence. So you testified that you said good evening to Max that night. You must enjoy asking incredibly obvious questions. You say good morning in the morning and good afternoon during the day. It's obvious that I'd say good night to someone at night. What, Ben, you've got something I'd add? Let me guess, that's not it, Trilo, you say good evening at night? I'm sorry, Trilo. Mr. Quist, I would prefer if you kept your ventriloquist sacks outside of the courtroom. Possible, a performer lives and breathes his performances, and you should know better. There's gonna be something wrong with this bit of testimony. Ben's half of the comedy act? Guessing that's a joke side. Isn't that a bit strange to you? What do you mean? Well, if you hate Max, why would you bother being nice to him? It strikes me as somewhat strange. What would it strike you as strange? Exactly, how is it strange to be cordial to one of your co-workers? Well, if it is simply just being cordial to a co-worker, I would understand. That hurt! Maybe you should think of having some proof before your lips start flapping next time. Proof is everything in this world. You should have learned that back in grade school. There's no reason the Trilo would have ever say something nice to Max. But how do I go about proving that with the evidence? Bluffing is everything in this world. I'm sure you already learned that one. I guess I'll give it a shot. The witness will resume his testimony. I'm absolutely sure it was him. I saw Maximilian Galactica at the scene. I'm absolutely sure it was him. I saw Maximilian Galactica at the scene. I think I've already read that, though. I think I just read that twice. You're 100% sure of what you just said. I told you already. Jeez, I'm 100% absolutely sure. There's no way that he could be any more confident than that, right? There's no way I could mistaken someone wearing those three ridiculous symbols. Those three ridiculous symbols, huh? Out of curiosity, exactly how many times have you asked that question by now? You can ask it again. I'll answer with a chorus. Everyone together now. Thank you very much. Mia, you didn't have to join in, did you? It's fun shouting out with everyone else. Must be a hole in his testimony somewhere. I agree, but do we have the proof to make something stick? All we can do is try, right, Nick? Well, we've got to have something that will be proved useful. Alright, time to go to work. Maybe that I was waiting, okay? But that doesn't change the fact that I saw him. Showed up after I'd been waiting for about 5 minutes. Said good evening to him, but he didn't even acknowledge my presence. Okay, what about the bottle? Objection! Trilo, is it not true that you had a fight with Max on the day of the murder? A fight? A fight over Regina, to be exact. It wasn't that big of a deal, it was just an argument, a disagreement at most. A disagreement usually doesn't end with someone getting clocked over the head. Oh yeah, and his puppet went missing. Oh. So he couldn't have been there last night, okay, I get it now. The morning, Ben got clobbered over the head by Max, didn't he? What? Is that an admission of assault and battery? Wait, assault and... Oh, I get it, because assault and manslaughter, but it's assault and battery, because he's a puppet. Before we handle that, we should wrap up the defendant's murder change first. The truth is that on the day of the crown, the defendant and witness had a huge fight. There's absolutely no way they would have suddenly become cordial. There is absolutely no way they would have suddenly become cordial that evening. Moreover, just consider the personality of the witness on stand. There's no way a puppet this loon would just up and say good evening to his rival. Are you saying this witness is lying? That he's trying to frame the defender by claiming to have seen him at the crime scene? I didn't tell a single lie! Honestly, I just... That's enough from you, Mr. Quist. Mr. Wright. Yes, Your Honor. Let's clarify the testimony for this court. Could you explain your theory about who the witness actually saw that night? He saw a different person? It is my belief that the witness did indeed see someone that night. It was just someone else. That's who we said good evening to.
What kind of theory is that?
The correct one. Furthermore, I don't believe the person the witness saw was Max at all.
What?
If he had truly met Max that night, there would have been no greeting at all. Which means there was only one proper answer. The person the witness saw that night was not Maximilian Galactica. That is why Trilo made the effort to greet whoever it was that he saw that evening. Or good evening, as he put it.
What in the world?
But the defendant kindly explained who it was Trilo saw that evening. I think it was Russell. Considering the ill temper of this witness, there is only one person he would greet. It must be Regina. It's Regina, right? She's so cute. No, Your Honor, it is not Regina. If it was Regina, Trilo would have given her the engagement ring as a present. Oh, yeah, I suppose you've got a point there. It was Russell Berry, the victim himself. Exactly. You were correct, it was indeed Russell Berry. The person you saw that evening was the victim, the ringmaster, Russell Berry. That's why you greeted him, Trilo. Isn't that correct? Answer the question, Mr. Quest. Oh, sorry, I keep on clicking that. Order, order! How do you respond to this?
Wait a second. Well, at first I thought it was the old man, but once I got a better look at him, it was obviously Maximilian Galactica.
I think it is high time that we clear the air about this question. Mr. Quist obviously witnessed a single person in the area at the plaza that evening. The problem is identifying exactly who that person was. Was it Maximilian Galactica? Or was it Ringmaster, one Mr. Russell Berry? The prosecution argues that it was the defendant that the witness saw that night. The witness had clearly stated that he saw the defendant's three symbols.
Three symbols?
Oh my god! Yes, yes, we know. The silk hat, cloak, and white roses. Thank you! I don't have to hear it again! I mean, read it again. The silk hat and a cloak, anyone would wear them. They'd even look good on me. What was that? Well, the witness had endlessly repeated that he saw Max's three symbols. However, how do we really know it was Maximilian Galactica? Could have been someone else dressed up as him. Possibly even Russell Berry.
What?
Miss Von Karma, do you have a clear evidence that the person the witness saw was the defendant?
Well, I...
If that's the case, then it is impossible for me to make a judgment at this point. Yes, I think we've finally won a point in this one. It is very unfortunate. Huh? You're just a little too excited for your own good, Mr. Phoenix Wright. What do you mean by that? Oh, come on, I keep on... You merely established one thing from this witness. You established that this witness saw one person in the plaza that night. I applaud you on your effort, but... Who was that person? Who that person was can only be answered by the next witness. Your Honor, the prosecution will provide beyond a shadow of a doubt an answer to that question, evidence that clearly establishes one thing. There is no one other than a Maximilian Galactica responsible for this crime. Very well. The court will take a 10-minute recess. During that time, I request the prosecution prepare their next witness. Court is now in session. In recess. Never mind. Sorry. To be continued. Yep, let's save. September 29, 11:54 a.m. District Court, Defendant Lobby Number 5.
Sweetie, you have to believe me. I didn't go anywhere near that crime scene.
So then where were you when the murder took place?
We talked about it yesterday, remember?
I was in the Ringmaster's room.
And while you were there, it was the Ringmaster who left the room, right?
Exactly. He told me to wait in the room because he would be right back.
That's when the Ringmaster headed to the scene of the crime, right?
That's what it seems like.
But the Ringmaster must have been wearing Max's costume, right?
Oh, sweetie, I just remembered. I went straight to the Ringmaster's room still dressed in my stage clothes. But when I got there, I went ahead and took the costume off.
Which means...
means that the ringmaster could have taken his costume and went out looking like Max. Fabulous, it's a fabulously possible possibility.
Well done, Nick.
However, sweetie, why would the ringmaster want to dress up like me? Isn't that a bit strange? If you think about it, all they found at the crime scene was my silk hat. What about my cloak? Where did that go? Double, Well, Max, I never thought of that. You should be a detective or something. Well, I was never quite sure what to be when I grew up. Magician or president.
You have no idea how hard it was to make a decision.
That's really cool. Fabulous, this mystery just keeps getting deeper. And I'm saying fabulous. December 29, 12:06 p.m. District Court, courtroom number 2.
Now that everyone is back, let's get started. The court is now back in session. Ms. Von Karma, please proceed with the prosecution's case.
Very well. I will now call my next witness, a pitiful clown with the unfortunate distinction of having seen the entire thing. Well, Mr. Lawrence Curls, please take to the stand.
Why'd you just call him a pitiful clown?
So that's his name, Lawrence. Oh, he's sad.
The witness will state his name and occupation for the court record.
In West Clanadophobia. What?
Name and occupation.
What was. What did he say? While it's paused right here, I'm just gonna have a. You can probably see it now. I'm gonna have a screenshot up just so you can read what it said, and I'll read it later. I'm sorry. I'm just not used to being in court. I've never been in a courtroom like life. I wasn't quite sure what joke is best suited to this sort of occasion.
What in the world are you talking about? You're in a grand hall of justice and some comedy club.
Since it's easy to see your occupation, please state your name for the court.
Oh, yeah. Maybe this joke is okay.
Mom, do I have to wear pants? The sign only says no shirts, no shoes, no service.
Yep. Okay, the silence got me. Okay, how about this? Have you seen my proctologist, Dr. Seymour Butts? That was someone. But a couple of clowns. Okay, I'm putting a screenshot up of that one as well right now. Yep. Lawrence Coles, professional funny man, also known as Murder Clown. You witnessed the scene at around 10:15 p.m. the day of the murder,
correct?
Yes, yes it is. Very well, Mr. Curls, will you please testify to what you saw that evening?
A rabbi, a priest, and a Rastafarian walked into the plaza. Without the humor, please.
Okay.
Oh, poor Murray can't be his normal stoogy self in court.
Oh, poor Carrot.
I know, I'm not the greatest comedian in the world. I haven't been able to make people laugh for 10 years.
Okay, the carrot's not moving.
I just realized there's a mouth on top of his hat. No matter what I saw, all I get is a return and a vacant stare and a polite applause. Since no one ever laughs at my jokes, I've taken to laugh at them myself. It's a bad habit, but hey, at least I'm trying. Imagine my predicament. I'm a clown who can't make people laugh. I'm almost useless. To keep trying, I even tried to come up with jokes just for today. Just this atmosphere is very nerve-wracking. I started trying to make everyone laughing. Seriously, everyone, what do you think of me? How am I doing?
Aren't we the ones supposed to be asking the questions here?
Witness.
Huh?
We will listen to your call for help after the court proceedings are over. Thus, please stick with the facts of this case.
Really? You'll really hear me out?
Well, I'll make sure that one of my staff will be your straight man later.
Thank you, I can't wait.
Poor Gumshoe.
Now that that's settled, shall we begin once again with the testimony?
Of course we can. I'll talk for as long as you want.
Yay, he's smiling again!
The night of the murder, after practice was over, I went straight back to my room. No idea how tired I was that night, I was pooped. I thought I'd go straight to sleep. Before I did, I glanced out the window. That's when I saw two silhouettes. They were a bit far away, though. It was the ringmaster, and he was with Max, who was wearing his cloak. I kept watching them, and all of a sudden, Max clumps their headmaster over the ringmaster over the head. When are they going to bring the fact out that there's no killer for Prince? It's very interesting. If this eyewitness account is believed, I have enough to pass judgment right now. Of course you can. There's no way that this account can be criticized. However, the witness is a bit, how do you say, off-kilter. Almost like he has some sort of atmosphere of guilt surrounding him. That must be because of my insincere smile. Mr. Wright, please begin the defense's cross-examination.
Yes, Your Honor.
Nick, you've got to find some kind of contradiction in his testimony.
I know that.
Mr. Wright.
Your Honor? I'm afraid that if you push this witness too far, it would bring disaster upon the court. Thus, I sincerely hope you are not going to engage in pointless saber-rattling.
I understand, Your Honor.
If you can cause this kind of distraction from the facts, I'll hold you responsible.
How am I responsible? I'm not the one with the corny jokes.
Is that meant to be a hint to saying don't hold everything? Or press everything, whichever one? I don't know. The night of the murder after the practice. Okay, let's just do this. Pressed one again, accidentally. And two, great. You'd say the practice wrapped up around 10 PM, correct? See, that's the thing. How exactly am I supposed to make a joke about 10 PM? Now, 8 o'clock, that's something a clown can riff off of. Let's just pretend it was 8 o'clock. Let's not make it 8 o'clock, alright, Mo? What do you mean, let's not? Don't take the clown out of the clowning already. Come on, Nick, just listen to his joke. There are 3 reasons why I don't want to. 1, I probably won't laugh. 2, I'll get hit with a penalty. 3, I'll get whipped. Will the witness just proceed with his factually testimony? You're so boring. I actually want to hear what his joke was going to be. Oh, wait, no, wrong one. You know, you want to hear the joke. A man goes to his doctor, and the doctor asks, how is the number 1? Man says every day at 6, the doctor asks, what about 2? Put in the screenshot up, I guess. These are exactly the types of jokes you should say for gumshoe.
You knew what would happen. Don't look at me like that.
Mr. Wright, you're hereby penalized. This will not become a kangaroo court.
I'll just get all that back by finishing someone's locks. This isn't funny at all, in more ways than one. You have no idea how tired I was that night. I was pooped.
You were pooped that night?
Yes, I was very, very tired, not to mention I had some bad Mexican food.
What?
The double cheese double. Bean enchilada is a dangerous menu item. What happened after that, as they say, happens. Okay. That one was cool, huh? I hear the kids really love toilet humor these days. That joke was so hip, I don't want to ruin it with a reply. Got a good reply, though. That joke was so funny, it just...
What the fuck? I'm pressing him! Oh my god. Okay, I'm gonna save. So then I can go back in case I get another penalty!
That's when I saw 2 silhouettes. They were a bit far away, though.
Far away, you say? If you had to say exactly, how far were they?
Let me think about that for a second. If my room was here, and they looked about, yay, big, I'd say they were about 30 feet from my window.
Just 30 feet? That's not far at all.
It was snowing that night, and it cut down on visibility. I see. Please continue with your testimony regarding the 2 shadows.
It was the ringmaster, and he was with Max, who was wearing his cloak.
You'd say you clearly saw this, even though you were, by your own admission, far away. That's right. I'd been thinking about it over and over since that night, but things didn't really make sense until I spoke with the prosecutor, Ms. Von Karma. Now I'm 100% certain that it was Max and the ringmaster that I saw that night. Just think about it, how could I be wrong if Max is always wearing his uppity symbols?
Uppity symbols?
Lawyers nowadays, do you even have to go to school anymore to be one? Alright, everyone knows what the- oh my god. See what I mean? It's always like this. The crowd never wants to go along with me. I must really be utterly and completely worthless as a clown.
Yowza! Enough foolishness, get back on the track.
Will the witness please testify as to what he saw and only what he saw?
I kept watching them and all of a sudden Max clonked the ringmaster over the head.
You say you saw the ringmaster get clonked over the head?
Yes, I did. It's the climax of my story. He really does enjoy the complete random non sequitur.
What would you say the victim was struck with?
You mean weapon? I have no idea.
A weapon wasn't found in the murder scene, right?
No. You did say you saw the entire thing, didn't you?
Well, yeah, I suppose I did.
Wait, no, I didn't. I didn't see a weapon.
Mo, did you or did you not see the crime of a murder committed that night?
I will not permit you to harass my witness in this manner.
You'd better have an excellent reason for attacking this poor, poor clown.
Because if you don't, you know what is waiting for you.
A nice penalty.
Go. Wasn't that a bit melodramatic?
So what will it be then, Mr. Phoenix Wright?
Do you have any clear basis to believe that my witness did not see the crime?
I don't know. I have to go with yes, because if I don't, then...
Of course I have grounds to make this claim. Let's hear it. That's something I can't share with you at this time.
What did you say, Mr. Wright?
I know there's something wrong with this testimony, but I can't put why I feel this way into words for the judge.
Maybe we should get a bit more information.
Once we find something more solid, we can give it another.
Yeah, you're right.
Mr. Wright, before we resume your testimony, you know that you must be penalized. Oh my god!
It's enough. This court sees no reason to further that prolong.
Oh boy.
I don't even care about skipping this. I'm not even gonna pause, I'm just gonna get back to where I was.
Oh my god.
Bullshit. This is complete bullshit.
Okay, here we are.
Sir, them? This one doesn't really matter. That one does matter.
That one doesn't matter. That one does matter, I mean.
I saw two silhouettes. Yeah, this is when I saw this one. Doesn't matter.
Far away, you say? Okay, already read that. Yeah.
Ringmaster, stuff like that.
Kept watching them, and all of a sudden, Max clonked their headmaster over the head.
Wait, should I?
Yeah, I noticed. We've just got to pinpoint what's changed.
You can do it, Nick.
What did he tell us last time?
Basically what happened there was, it's one of your most straightforward court sessions ever. I was like, of course, you penalize me if I don't.
Oh, sorry. Whoa. Didn't mean to do that. You just happened to glance out the window. Keep pressing. Exactly, why did you look at your window that night? Why? Why? Clowns don't need a reason to look out their windows, do they? That's not what I meant. I meant that, well, when we spoke yesterday. Once I had tucked myself into bed, I heard this amazing noise. It was incredibly loud. It sounded like a giant thump. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. You forgot? Your Honor, the witness looked out of his window upon hearing a loud noise. He did not just simply glance out of his window that night. Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot to mention that thump, didn't I? Okay, gonna put up that screenshot of the thing as well. Here, there you go. That's not something you just forgot about. Yeah, what she said. I believe it would be best if Mo were to revise his testimony. Very well. Mr. Curls, please revise your testimony. This should start turning the tables in our favor. I heard a huge noise outside the window, and that's what made me take a look outside. What was the sound like? Well, I guess it kind of sounded like, I guess you could say... Mr. Curls, may the court remind you that humor is unnecessary. How'd you know that I was going to make a joke? I guess that the sound sounded like a... I suppose it sounded like someone getting hit with something very hard. Yep, that's what it sounded like, honestly. Someone getting hit, huh? What then? You went to look out the window and you saw... That's when I saw the silhouettes. Far away, you say. Okay. Should be something new. Okay, then. Maybe not. Which reminds me. He says he didn't see the weapon. Okay, so I need to go to the ICAP one. Because he never saw the weapon. Means he never saw. Nice penalty, it's always going to be my full bar. Of course I do. He never saw the crime. He never saw the crime. He wasn't an eyewitness. Got a great reason to make your claim. I suppose you will be telling us all that great reason. Of course I will. The reason is the witness's very own testimony. What's the meaning of that? Mo said that he heard a sound like a thump of someone getting hit. He did say that. However, Mo just stated that following under oath. I kept watching them, and all of a sudden Max clonked the ringmaster over the head. If Mo is to be believed when he says he looked out the window upon hearing a sound, there's no way that he could have seen Max clonk anyone. In 1972, I'll put that up here as well. Mr. Curls, how do you respond to Mr. Wright's assessment? They didn't commit. These clowns promptly escaped from a maximum security clown car. Mr. Curls, are you reciting the C-Team theme to anger this court? No, I'm just stalling for time while I jog my memory. Great job, Nick. These types of witnesses always seem to have a selective memory. You just have to peel back the lawyers of the clown makeup to find the truth. Well, you're back from your jog. Well, it pretty much happened the way I said. Pretty much. Well, when I looked out my window that night, the ringmaster was already face down in the snow. The prosecution helped me fill in the gaps of my statement. Von Karma. Tampering with witnesses again. I'm gonna kill you. So now are you saying that you did not see the defendant clonk the ringmaster? Yes. When I looked out my window, the ringmaster had already checked out. Checked out? Yep, he was on permanent vacation, as they say. Your Honor, you did not witness the actual crime. You still say you saw the criminal, right? Yes, exactly. The ringmaster was slumped over and I saw someone's silhouette next to him. Very well, then please testify to this silhouette you saw. And if I even catch a hint of a joke from you, I'll put you in a holding cell until you learn court etiquette. Got it? Got it. The silhouette. I was a bit far away, but that shadow could only have belonged to Max. There's no doubting it, especially since I saw his uppity symbols. His silk hat, that black cloak, they were all there. His face was silhouetted, but there was no doubt that it was him. His cloak was fluttering in the wind, so I couldn't really see what he was carrying. It does seem as if the defendant was at the scene of the crime. You took your time realizing that, didn't you? Whatever, that should be enough, right? Yeah, I definitely think this is Akira, because usually the starting scene of each chapter has something to do with the whatever, and I'm thinking in this case, since he's pretending, or maybe it's real flying, I don't know, but he was flying across the scene, maybe Akira feels jealous that he's trying to steal his acrobatics part, because yeah, an acrobat is someone who does tricks throughout the air, and at the moment, the magician, Max, is flying through the air, so it could be jealousy. And maybe he had something against the headmaster, not the headmaster, the ringmaster, and so he dressed up as Max to frame him? Maybe. It's a decisive testimony. Was Max really at the crime scene that night? He said he wasn't there. We have to keep believing that. Alright, Mr. Wright, commence your cross-examination. Cross-examination, the silhouette. I was a bit far away, but the show. Okay. Don't you think that you were going a little overboard with how explicit you are? The shadows belong to Max is an awfully firm statement, don't you think? What are you getting at? I'm just saying that one of your fellow performers' life is on the line here. Are you truly 100% absolutely certain that it was Max? I'm not the kind of person who would lie about something as serious as this. Silhouette I saw was Max, I'm convinced of that. Doesn't seem like he's jumping to any conclusion this time. Let's go over this again then. What makes you so sure that you saw Max that night? Okay then. Alright, so this one, I'm gonna do the primer poster. You say you saw all of Max's uppity symbols. I suppose so, they're still counting the cloak, right? Mo, everyone knows that Max Manley Galactica has three uppity symbols. Three symbols? Yeah, everyone get ready, all together now! Oh my god. White roses. Who cares if he knew that there were three or not? He saw what he saw, and he saw the symbols, he just forgot to mention one. Isn't that right, Mo? Do you like pie? I love pie! Oh my... I am posting a photo of that right now. One look at that and you'll probably realize where I'm going like this. Yeah. Order! Order! Mo, you didn't see the roses. To be honest, there wasn't any roses on the person I saw. The crime scene was dark. It's obvious it was too dark to see that kind of detail. But the witness, he said he was able to see the silhouette of the criminal's face. Not to mention the roses are white, there's no way he could have missed them. And the roses must have fallen off when the defendant assaulted the victim. If that was the case, and the police would have found them near the crime scene. Mr. Wright, are these white roses truly material to the facts of this case? Clearly not, he's just toying with his court. I got her on the whatever, I think it's like defense. Whenever there's a nugget of truth, it always seems to peek out at me, then run away. Someone is toying with the court, but it's not me. Your Honor, do you recall Trilo's testimony? There's no way I could mistake someone wearing those three ridiculous symbols. How can you mistake someone with that crazy getup and his nose stuck up so high? How could you mistake someone with such a snobby three-piece getup? Trilo saw them all. Trilo saw all three of Max's symbols. However, this witness claims there were no white roses on the person he saw. There was absolutely no doubt that this is a contradiction. Now what am I supposed to think? One is supposed to disregard the pointless. But this... Judge, forget the roses, think about his other testimony. The witness has stated without a doubt that he saw Maximilian Galactica. Nothing else matters, let's wrap this case up now. Your Honor, it may be trivial, but there should still be a doubt lingering in your mind. Frankly, I have my doubts about this witness. Seems that unlike wine, the witness has not grown more mature with age. I'm not mature? I've come to a conclusion. I'm 99% certain that this witness saw the defendant. However, my remaining 1% of doubt is quite reasonable. Which means that for my peace of mind, I'm going to request a bit more testimony. What? There are no contradictions in his next testimony. In his next statement, I'm preparing to issue a ruling. A ruling? Nick, is this your last chance? This is your last chance, I'm sorry. The Silhouette Part 2. There's no doubt in my mind, there was no white roses that night. However, all of the other symbols were there, I'm equally sure of that. Especially the silk hat. There was no way I could forget seeing the decorations on it. He was wearing it the entire time that he was on the scene. But he took it off. Mr. Wright, you've got your one last chance at this. Just one chance? I would not allow even the slightest hint of badgering against a witness. If you were going to prove to me that there is a contradiction with Mr. Curl's statement, you'd better have at least a shred of evidence to back up your accusations. I've only got a single shot at this, I've got to be careful. I understand, Your Honor. One chance is all I will need. Oh god. Alright, I know which one it is. So no doubt in my mind, got it. This wouldn't happen to be a silk hat you saw that night, would it? Yep, that's it. That's the hat he was wearing that night. No question in your mind? Exactly. How would one mistake a thing like that? I see. Is there some sort of problem, Mr. Wright? Miss Von Karma, where exactly was the silk hat found? Must you always ask these questions? It was found at the crime scene. The crime scene? That means... The silk hat fell off at the crime scene. However, the witness clearly testified to the contrary. The witness stated that he was wearing it the entire time that he was on the scene. That's not true! Yes, Your Honor. What is the meaning of all this? You are old enough to know better than to behave like this in court. Hey, that's just not right. That's so harsh. What's not right here is your eyesight and your memory, amongst other things. What? Why are you being so mean to me? What did I do? Let me guess, you just don't like my jokes or something, right? You didn't have to go and insult my eyesight or my memory, they're both great. Seriously, why? Just because you were sitting above me. No matter how old I get, I'll always be younger than you. Ah! Enough of these childish outbursts, Mr. Curls. Who do you think you are? I saw him, I swear I saw him. It was Max. Even if he didn't have his roses, he was still wearing his dumb silk hat. I'm telling you the truth. Turns into a bratty little kid. It's pitiful, isn't it? He left the scene wearing that dumb silk hat. He was there. He left the scene? What's the matter, Nick? It's something I've been mulling over for a while now. Murr. You just said that he left the scene. Exactly how did the murderer leave the scene of the crime? He went. What do you mean, how did he leave the scene? You can't ask me that. Mr. Phoenix Wright is badgering the witness, Your Honor. The witness testimony is so full of holes, Miss Von Karma. Protect. Miss Von Karma's protect is useless. You've got a point. Let's hear what the witness has to say on this matter. Is that alright with you? Don't talk to me like I'm a little baby. Besides, what kind of stupid question is how did he leave the crime scene? The answer's obvious. He just turned around and walked away. That's what I expected you to say. You say that's how it happened. Huh? I'm not sure I know exactly where you're going with this. Lawyers nowadays sure do love to harp on the smallest things. Do you have any proof to counter his story as to how the criminal left the scene? Look at this picture. The problem is the footprints in the snow. Footprints? In this photo, we can clearly see the footprints of the victim. However, where are the criminal's footprints? They aren't there. Ay, 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 ay! Sir Mo, exactly how did the criminal escape the scene?
Your Honor, this witness has already proven that his testimony is completely unreliable. I move to strike all of the witness's testimony from the court record.
I agree.
This clown's testimony is as rickety as the clown car he came to court in.
Wait just a second.
You guys can't just ignore everything I've said. Fine, I'll tell you the truth this time.
You wait a second. I think you've just said more than enough for today.
That didn't hurt. I'm sick and tired of listening to you anyways. I'll give you the real deal this time, I swear.
I don't know why I get the bad feeling things are gonna get worse before they get better.
Mr. Lawrence Curls.
Yes?
The testimony you provided up until now has been false? It hasn't been false, I haven't lied, it's just
what?
It's just I was a bit confused in the bit about the criminal leaving the scene. Especially since Von Karma and her whip told me not to talk about what I really saw.
Order! I will have order! Francisca Von Karma, how could you?
Your Honor, if you had heard the truth from the witness, you would have exactly the same opinion as I have.
What opinion is that? It's not funny.
That's enough out of you. I'm going to listen to what he has to say.
Now then, let's hear the truth about what you say you saw.
You're not going to believe this, but it's all true, I tell you.
True not to waste our time with your idiotic drive.
Drivel or whatever.
What's the bet? He flew away.
Now it's time for our next segment, Mo Knows.
Everything that I've said up until now has been a truce.
When I looked out the window, the ringmaster was down and Max was standing above him. He wasn't wearing his white roses, but he was wearing the silk hat.
That's when I saw he.
This is the truth now! Get ready for it! He flew! He jumped and flew through the air!
He flew right off and disappeared into the darkness.
That's why there were no footprints. Flying people don't leave footprints.
Oh my god.
I told you it wasn't funny.
Do you believe me now?
Oh boy. I just...
Well, that was, how do you put this into words? Maximilian Galactica is a world-class magician. But to leave the scene of a crime by flying, there's no way that actually happened.
You're right.
Why is she right?
You believed the other witnesses. Why would you believe me, especially since it's the best part of the story?
To be honest, this is the first time I've heard of a flying criminal.
What do you think about this witness's testimony, Mr. Wright?
These eyes are playing tricks.
It's obvious that the witness's eyes are playing tricks on him.
Don't be such a fool. Who in the world do you think I would make that mistake that joke for, sorry.
Jeez, I didn't say you were lying.
Wow, he looks really serious right now. More serious than he's looked all day.
I suppose I will let you all in on my thinking regarding this matter. The criminal disappeared into the sky. I'd love to believe that. But I just can't wrap my head around how that could actually happen.
You imbecile.
If you disregard a need for proof, Ms. Von Karma's case is sound. However, I've got this feeling that this case is in dire need of more investigation.
Thus, I will conclude today's proceedings at this point. It's an undisputed fact that the criminal left no footprint at the scene. Tomorrow, I want us to find out the reason behind this mystery of mysteries. I believe that's enough for today. Court is now in recess.
Hey, sweeties, what in the world is going on?
Sorry, that's what I want to know.
They say the criminal flew off into the sky and disappeared. Max, I can't believe I'm asking this, but you didn't fly that night, did you?
I know you didn't mean to ask me such a fabulously stupid question. I can't fly whenever I please, it's not that easy. but it looks so effortless for you on stage. It's not that simple. I'm not actually flying on stage. I use invisible wires and have them hoist me through the air.
Wow, you just told me the secret to your magic.
No, I brought the first rule, the cardinal rule, the only rule! I'm sorry, Max.
I'm sorry you had to break the magician's creed to keep the magic's trick secret.
Nick, what do we do now? All we can do now is hope we can find the flying criminal in court tomorrow. Great idea. Let's do our best to catch this sucker.
It's definitely the acrobat. It's definitely Acro. An acrobat would be able to figure out exactly how to look like it's flying. Like, maybe he scaled the wall or something and made it so quick that it seemed like it was flying.
That could be possible, because people in these types of games don't understand what parkour is.
Otherwise, that will be the end of this court session. It's gone for about an hour and 30 minutes, nearly. So, I'll see you guys next time.